such thing as spring. I love but you.
You were sent from heaven just for me, and you are also heavenly.
Hi, this is Barry Papernick, and welcome back. This is hour number two of what I'm calling the Lost Harry Prime Tapes, a radio program from WNPV in Lansdale, Pennsylvania, recorded November of 1999 with disc jockey Chuck Irwin and big band singer Harry Prime. Some great stories in here. I think you're going to enjoy it. And we pick up hour number two with the story about the Mills Brothers.
Donald Mills, the last surviving member of the groundbreaking Mills Brothers singing group, has died. He was 84. A family friend says Mills died Saturday at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles of complications from pneumonia. The Mills Brothers started performing in 1922 and sold an estimated 50 million records. They scored their very first hit with their 1928 recording of Tiger Rag.
Home at night, she will be waiting.
I'm Larry Webb, AP Network News.
Two different tours with them, with Randy Brooks and his orchestra, and another extensive tour with the Mills Brothers. They traveled right on the bus with us, and that we played theaters and auditoriums all over the Midwest in the 50s and, 51, 52. And I'm telling you, they were the nicest guys in the world. We even had a thing where we had a shuffleboard tournament among the guys in the band. And my partner was the heavy set guy who died a few years back, Harry, the jolly guy that had the, sort of came up and did the second chorus.
Right.
But the romantic sounding one was the one who died today. That was the last of the Mills Brothers. And I am really... that's a crusher to me tonight.
Yes, it is. That's a
because
sad moment.
The only time I was ever close to getting thrown in jail was because of an incident with the Mills Brothers, where I thought a hotel clerk in Evansville, Indiana, was a little abusive when we tried to check into a motel. Guy said something abusive to Skipper, that was the dad.
Mm-hmm.
He was 75 that night. We were going to have a party in a motel in Evansville, Indiana. And the guy said something to Skipper, and I was with my buddy, my roommate, Phil Giacobbe, and I heard this, and I said, wait a minute, Phil. And I went over, and So I flew off the handle, and I said something to him. And then he said something I didn't like, and then I went over the desk at him, and the first thing I know, they have a couple cops in the lobby, and Flanagan had to get me out to play the date that night. So the only way we could get Skipper and the Mills Brothers to celebrate the birthday was to rent a suite in this motel, and we did it, we defied them,
That's wonderful.
So we did it, and God bless them, we had a great time, and all I can say is, Donald, I hope the Lord has you in his hands tonight, because he was a good guy. All the Mills Brothers were wonderful people. Wonderful people.
They sounded like they were.
And I'm really sorry.
You could hear it through their music.
Back to the big countdown, Chuck. I'm sorry for taking
that
time out.
That's understandable.
But that really hit me like a body blow.
That was
because
kind of
I love those guys.
Yeah.
All right.
One of my favorites also. We'll try and get one in if we can tonight.
I hope so.
Yeah.
Because they did. Oh, man, you should have seen them at a concert. They just had the crowd going crazy. Number 17 on my list of top 10 bands, top 20 bands, as we're getting to the top. Wait till we get to the top 10. We even have sound effects for you. Oh, boy, it's going to be good. But we're at number 17 now. This was the guy that introduced... Every band had like a little novelty, a guy that was sort of the fun guy in the band and did the novelty tunes. Like Les Brown had Butch Stone, And Kay Kaiser had a guy by the name of Ishka Bibble. He came out and had this silly bang sort of haircut like one of the Three Stooges had, you know, like Moe had. And he sang songs, and it was all part of a bands were more than just bands to dance to. They entertained, and the people came up front, and they put on a show for you. And one of the guys who did it was Ishka Bibble with the Kay Kaiser Band. but they also had one of the best boy-girl duos singing, and this preceded Bob Eberly and Helen O'Connell, right before them, you know? And I'm talking about two of my favorites, Ginny Simms and Harry Babbitt, and why don't we do this more often? Number 17.
Why don't we do this more often?
Why don't we?
Just what we're doing tonight.
What a lovely night.
Gee, but it's great to get together again.
Sure is.
Why does it only happen now and then? We ought to do this more often. Mm-hmm. Don't you agree that I'm right? We make each other laugh. We make each other sing. And you can never, ever overdo a good thing. So, honey, why don't we do this more often?
Oh, you mean
just what we're doing tonight. Miss
a hug and a kiss. Oh, why don't we do this more often?
Mm-hmm.
Just what we're doing tonight.
I'm willing.
Oh, gee, but it's great to get together again. Why does it only happen now and then? Oh, we ought to do this more often.
Yeah.
Don't you agree that I'm right?
I do.
We make each other laugh. We make each other sing. And you can never, ever overdo a good thing. So why don't we do this more often?
Ooh, love it.
Just what we're doing tonight.
Everything all right?
Just fine.
We must do this more often, Harry.
I want to tell you, that's pretty effective, isn't it?
Yes,
that was
it is.
Harry Babbitt and Ginny Simms, and they were such
a great duet.
Excellent duet, yes. And why don't we do it? Kay Kaiser and his College of Musical Knowledge.
That's right.
Good band. Fun band, you know, not didn't knock you over with all kinds of wild arrangements, but very pleasant, very entertaining. Had a good time when you saw that band.
Probably the guys in it had a great time.
Exactly.
It just sounded like they were having the time of their lives. That's what it all is about. If you
found that when there were two places in New York that used to be what I'd call the hangouts for the band guys, you know. One was called Charlie's Bar on 7th Avenue. I think it was right opposite the Taft Hotel. And when you'd go in there, you could tell the guys that worked with the bands that were happy and the bands that were like a little unhappy that the public didn't appreciate the music they were playing, you know, the more progressive bands.
Right.
It was unbelievable the way you could tell the guys that were with the bands, that were making big money, or good money anyway, steady money. And they were the bands that pleased the audiences. They thought more about the audiences than they did about satisfying their musical advancement. You understand? Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
Okay.
Because you got to eat, you know what I mean?
Yeah. The way I always put it was, I used to notice that the guys that played with Kenton used to be borrowing money from the guys that played with Lombardo.
That's right.
You know what I mean? That's what I noticed. Not that I didn't appreciate Kenton. I loved what Kenton did, but it was a hard sell in at that particular time.
You know, say what you want, but Guy was raking in the bucks.
He certainly was, because he went out of his way to be friendly with the audience, and he was doing that New Year's Eve thing, and so on and so forth. Okay, what do you have? Where do we go to now?
We are now up to number 16.
Number 16.
And this gentleman was a trombonist, arranged for such great bands as Gene Goldcat, Fletcher Henderson, and the Dorseys, and was also a great composer.
Oh, Chuck's choice is?
He composed such great pieces of music as Someone Else Is Taking My Place, You're Nobody Until Somebody Loves You.
Oh, Chuck.
We're talking about Music in the Morgan Manor.
Oh, I love this guy.
He was Russ Morgan, and another composition that he wrote, and a big hit from the year 1948, So Tired.
Saving my love for you. So tired of dreaming daydreams. So tired of only play schemes. Why don't you call me? Call me tonight, my dear. Tell me that your thoughts are all of me, sweetheart. All day long I wonder why we're far apart. So tired of dreaming of you. So tired of waiting for you. But though I'm tired, I'll wait forever, dear.
Russ Morgan and his orchestra, and So Tired, number 16.
That was such that sound, that trombone, and his voice. You know, people just love the Russ Morgan band. And I was telling you, Chuck, a few minutes ago, One night we were sitting there at a recording session, and I was, you know, we were talking about different guys that trombonists. Dorsey was sitting there, and there was Doc Severinsen and Louis Belson and Buddy DeFranco. They were all sitting around. It was in between sessions when we did Until. We were doing triple sessions. And Dorsey started talking about trombonists, and he said that he thought that the guy that took the most chances and was fearless as a trombone player and that he respected more than anyone else was Russ Morgan. I was surprised to hear that. He said, this guy, you know, it's all based on slide, the trombone, like, unless it's a valve trombone. But you can hit the worst notes in the world if you don't know how to position that slide whereas a trumpet is like a lot of pressure, and then you have reeds with the saxophones. But that slide is so important to a great trombonist, and the most fearless ones are the ones that squeeze those notes out with that slide. And Dorsey was high in his praise of Russ Morgan.
Yes,
boy,
indeed.
That's a good choice.
Yeah, so what's your choice for number 16?
Well, let's see. I have a trumpet player that was the first. He was in the first trumpet section that I ever sang with when I sang with a big orchestra. And when I went on the Chesterfield show, I looked back, and these were all guys that I had, legendary guys that I had been playing, you know, reading their names on record labels and all. Like, I looked back, and I saw Will Bradley, and I saw Buddy Morrow, and I saw Billy Rausch, and I looked in the trumpet section, and I saw, oh my, there's Billy Butterfield, my oh my, Chris Griffin, Jimmy Maxwell, and I thought, boy, what an all-star band, and that was the band I was going to sing with on the Chesterfield show. So we've chosen as my, 15?
Number 15.
Yeah, 15. Billy Butterfield, one of the greatest trumpet players of all time. He had a big one with Margaret Whiting, if you remember, on Moonlight in Vermont.
Oh, wait a minute. This is number 16. I'm sorry.
Oh, 16.
I'm getting
okay,
ahead of
yeah.
myself.
Yeah, it
all
is
right.
16. We're at 16, folks.
That's
all right.
Okay.
And it's that great trumpet player, one of the best of all time, Billy Butterfield, and Malagueña.
Thank you.
Malanguena, the great sound of Billy Butterfield and his trumpet, and Ernesto Cuona composition. At 7:24 here on 1440 AM, WNPV's Echoes of an Era, the Big Band Countdown.
That was number 16, Chuck, in
yes,
my book.
It was. Okay, very nice.
All right.
And we'll be back with number 15 as soon as I play a few messages here, and we'll be back with my pick for number 15 as Echoes of an Era Countdown continues.
And this station.
7:26 here on 1440 AM, WNPV's Echoes of an Era, and we're counting down the top 20 of the best of the big bands, and my pick for number 15, we're going to go across the ocean for this one, Harry.
Oh, boy. Sounds like, you know, they had great bands over there.
They certainly did.
I'm waiting to hear it.
And one of the best of the bands over there was one of the most popular bands in England in the 1930s, and he came to this country and selected probably one of the most top-notch arranger he could find to put together a band for him here in 1934, that being Mr. Glenn Miller.
Ooh.
And he also wrote the theme song for Charlie Barnett's band, Cherokee. We're talking about Mr. Ray Noble. Famous theme song, The Very Thought of You, as we count down the top 20 big bands here on Echoes of an Era with my special guest, Harry Prime. And Harry will have his number 15 pick coming up in just a moment, right after the Suburban Weather Scope forecast.
Here's the forecast for Bucks and Montgomery counties for tonight. Partly cloudy and colder. Lows are going to be in the upper 30s. We'll see wind gusts over 20 miles per hour. A mix of sun and clouds, blustery and chilly tomorrow. Highs in the upper 40s. For Monday night, partly cloudy, cold, lows around 30 degrees. Continued blustery and chilly on Tuesday, partly sunny skies, lower 40s. Sunshine on Wednesday in the mid-40s, and then getting a little milder in the 50s on Thursday. For Info Radio, this is John Bothy.
And currently outside of our studios here in Lansdale, 55 degrees, also 55 degrees in Audubon, 56 degrees in Ambler, and 56 in Abington. Relative humidity, 80%. Barometric pressure steady, 29.55. Winds out of the west at 10 miles per hour. Cloudy skies, 55 degrees at WNPV. And our special guest, Harry Prime, as we count down the top 20 best of the big bands, counting up to the millennium. And I guess we're up to number 15.
We're up to number 15, yeah, Chuck. And there, I'd like to take care of one little thing, though, because if I don't do it now, I'll forget it. But last Wednesday, I had a very nice day honoring a gentleman, who a senior citizen, who is one of your biggest listeners, Chuck. He listens to Echoes of an Era every week with all the folks up here at Brittany Point, the nursing home up here.
Right, yeah.
And his name is Emmanuel Hendricks. And Emmanuel and I have we finally met last Wednesday. I was at a birthday party for him and sang a few songs for him. And we had a good time. And he listens all the time. And I hope, Emmanuel, that you'll enjoy this number 15 pick from me. And it's another piano player, but a guy that was, I thought, of all the band leaders that I worked with, I think I liked this guy the most. He was a tremendous gentleman, and he was very popular with the Freddie Martin Band. And his name is Jack Fina on the piano doing the Bumble Boogie with Freddie Martin.
Certainly knew his way around a keyboard, didn't he?
Oh, boy. I can remember so many nights I worked. I didn't work long with the Jack Fina Band, but I spent about maybe 6-8 months. I got out as far as St. Louis at the Chase Hotel in St. Louis with him, and I remember having a picture taken in the lobby, and underneath the picture I later inscribed, "No bop, no beat, just Bumble Boogie." Myself and a fellow from Jersey City sat and had our picture taken, you know. It was all in jest, though. We really respected Fina, and he worked so hard at trying to push that band. And he died very young. I mean, I thought it was young anyway, and untimely. And a great guy, Jack Fina.
Okay.
With the Freddie Martin Band.
That's
and
right.
Where Freddie are we Martin. Now? Number 14?
We're up to number 14 now.
All right, here we're closing in on that top group.
Yes, we are. Okay, number 14. And this is, my list, of course, is based on record sales. So the number 14 pick was a popular sweet band leader. He played the saxophone and featured a singer named Skinny Ennis.
Chuck Irwin picks.
Mr. Hal Kemp.
Oh, boy.
And Got a Date with an Angel.
Got a Date with an Angel.
Climbing up the ladder of love to find the one who waits for me.
Got a date with an angel. Got to meet her at 7. Got a date with an angel. Now I'm on my way to heaven. She's so lovely beside me, and whatever betide me, got an angel to guide me. So I'm on my way to heaven. Soon I'll hear the bells ring out, and the choir will sing out, when the pearly gates swing out, or she'll beckon to me. Now I've been waiting a lifetime for this evening at 7. Got a date with an angel. Now I'm on my way to heaven.
At the beginning of the swing era, but a big hit from December of 1934, Hal Kemp and his orchestra with Skinny Ennis and Got a Date with Angel.
I don't know whether I ever told you, but Randy Brooks, who later had a band of his own and played and was a trumpet player with, did some great things with Les Brown, one of his early bands was the Hal Kemp Band. So you can hear how important that punctuated trumpet work, you know, the punctuations.
Oh, those triple tongues.
Yeah, it was a very precise band, and that was one of his big hits. Am I ready for number 14?
You are ready.
You better believe I am, Chuck. I have, this band. What a notorious band this was. Everybody, you know, you'd say, did they all make it on time? He had some bad boys in the band. And he came from a family. The dad was he had a high position in the New York Central Railroad. They were a money family. I think he went to an Ivy League college. But he was he loved the good time. But when that band went on, the guys went on the bandstand, it was one of the most enjoyable swinging big bands in America, and everybody loved them. And his name is Charlie Barnett, and it's Cole Porter's Night and Day.
Mm-hmm.
Burnett and his orchestra and Yankee Doodle.
Oh, boy. Did you hear the little licks they got in there?
I did. That was great.
What an outstanding arrangement. Who do you think did that arrangement, Chuck?
I don't know. I couldn't begin to tell you.
Of all people, Billy May.
Really?
Yep, for Charlie Barnett.
How about that?
Night and Day. And that was Charlie on the alto or soprano. It was either the alto or the soprano. I'm not sure, but he played both.
How about that?
But a great driving band. All right, here we go. We're up to what? 13?
Let's see. I do believe we are up to number 13.
This is the countdown, the Millennium Show. Is it the Echoes of an Era? This is Echoes of an Era.
Yes, it is.
I can't believe it sounds so great tonight, Chuck. What's going on?
I don't know.
Usually you're great, but tonight it's outstanding.
I understand. But, of course, we've got some outstanding music tonight because we got the best of the best. The top 20 big bands, you can't go wrong with that.
That must be why.
And that's it. Actually, after these messages, I'll be back with, we'll start with number 13 as soon as we get back.
Okay.
As Echoes of an Era continues. 7:45, and you're listening to Echoes of an Era, the best of the big bands, and our top 20 countdown with my special guest, Harry Prime. And, of course, tonight, we're not going to have Miller time, but...
Have you heard your big band yet? Well, it may be coming up in the next few, because we're going up to, 10 o'clock, Jeff?
That's right. And, of course, you know, with a top 20 countdown of the best of the big bands, you know Glenn Miller is going to be somewhere.
Favorite expression? Isn't it filler with Miller if we have time at the top?
Absolutely. He's going to figure very prominently in this list. But
you better believe it.
Right now, we're at number 13, and this gentleman took over the remains of the Gene Goldcat Orchestra.
Boy, what a job he had.
That was quite a band, too. But that was a band from the 1920s. Formed this back in 1927 and named his band after a Toronto nightclub. The only problem is the nightclub never opened. They were scheduled to play at the opening of this nightclub. They named their band after it, and the nightclub closed before they were even able to get there.
I think they reopened it when Fregosi went up there recently.
Perhaps so, but the only thing is the name stuck with them. They kept the name because they liked the name. It was very distinctive. And so it was led by a gentleman named Glenn Gray, the Casaloma Orchestra.
Wonderful band.
A wonderful band. And here's their wonderful theme song, Smoke Rings.
Woo!
Smoke
Glenn Gray and his Councilwoman Band and his famous theme song, Smoke Rings, at 7:48 on our Top 20 Countdown. And what's your pick for number 13, Mr. Harry Prime?
Well, after Glenn Gray, incidentally, we'll have a little more of Glenn Gray with another tune because I've picked them only a little higher up in the rankings, Chuck. But my pick for number 13, as we're moving up the line now, is the Guy Lombardo Band, Mr. New Year's Eve. And boy, this guy made friends for years and years with his brothers. And they had a very, very fine band. And it was one of those precision bands that everybody knew where they were going to be. Everybody was there for, you know, so many years, right in the same spot. And they made friends for many, many years at the big hotels all over the country. Guy Lombardo, the trio, and... Well, enjoy yourself, I think. That's what we're doing.
Yes, indeed we are.
You work and work for years and years. You're always on the go. You never take a minute off, too busy making dough. Someday you say you'll have your fun when you're a millionaire. Imagine all the fun you'll have in your old rocking chair.
Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think. Enjoy yourself while you're still in the pink. The years go by as quickly as a wink. Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think.
Yes, it is, it's later than you think. It's 10 minutes before 8 o'clock here on 1440 AM WNPV, and we're counting down our top 20 selections, and we'll be back with our picks for number 12, and me and my special guest, Harry Prime, as Echoes of an Era continues. 7:52 on Echoes of an Era, counting them down, the top 20, and we are at number 12. Or no, we're still at number 13. We got to get Harry's pick for number 13.
Really?
Oh, wait.
No, we're at number 12.
That's right, we are at number 12.
It's your turn.
All right,
yeah.
My turn. Okay.
I did enjoy yourself.
That's right. It's later than you think. That's what's pushing me around. We've heard from this gentleman once before this evening at number 19 on your list, but he's number 12 on the top selling records of the big bands.
Yeah.
Voiced baritone, trumpeter, and band leader. You know who that is.
Vaughan Monroe.
That's him.
Oh, boy.
And his famous theme song, Racing with the Moon.
Racing with the Moon. Racing with the Moon. High up in the midnight blue.
Band, a great voice, Vaughan Monroe, his famous theme song, Racing with the Moon, number 12. On the top 20 countdown, and we're up to, we got Harry's pick for number 12.
Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to have a little bit of Glenn Gray's Let's Dance, his impression of the Benny Goodman Band theme, Let's Dance.
Oh, that's right. He did a whole series of those,
did a whole series.
Oh, those were wonderful.
Of bands and their themes, and I tell you, it was great. And this one features Shorty Chirac on trumpet. Glenn Gray and the band with Let's Dance.
Let's Dance, the famous Benny Goodman theme song. That was done by Glenn Gray and his Casaloma band.
One of the most popular bands. You know, he was the guy that was really the most popular band in the country till Goodman came along with that concert in 1938 at Carnegie Hall.
That's right.
That sort of got the whole world spinning and jitterbugging and dancing and romancing.
Yes, indeed.
So Glenn had quite a career.
Yes, he did. Number 11. We'll move right along on our top 20 countdown of the best of the big bands and perhaps the single most important creative talent in American popular music. Now, that's quite a handful to say, but
how did you get that out?
I'm not sure. Don't ask me to repeat that, but
we don't have time.
Well, you're right. But once you hear the gentleman, you'll understand what I'm saying. He was born in Washington, D.C., and then he and his Washingtonians formed a band at the Cotton Club in 1927, had a wonderful arranger, Billy Strayhorn, who joined the band in 1939. Of course, we're talking about a gentleman who celebrated, well, we were celebrating the 100th anniversary of his birth this year, Mr. Edward Kennedy Ellington, Duke Ellington. Stomp your feet to that one, the famous Cottontail from 1940, Duke Ellington and his famous orchestra. As we continue our countdown to the millennium, and we're up to Harry Prime's prime pick for number 11.
Number 11, I have Larry Clinton and a public domain tune, Stephen Foster's Camptown Races. He was fabulous for doing this stuff. Larry Clinton.
Clinton Band and Camptown Races, doo-dah, doo-dah. As we count down the top 20 to the millennium, and we'll be back after AP News at 8 o'clock. We will have more of From 10 on as Echoes of an Era continues here on 1440 AM WNPV, so don't go away.
Listening to Echoes of an Era, the best of the big bands on 1440 AM, WNPV, Lansdale.
AP Network News, I'm Brian Thomas. President Clinton's trip to Europe is opening with a diplomatic coup. More on that from Mark.